He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
Well, he should. There are limits to what even I can do.
You know, I can't hear you.
Quiet. Just relax. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's...
I'll be okay.
We'll be down in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
'Cause I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut open?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
I know, but please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch, and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I can still hear you.
Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin.
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
Strong as an oak, this guy.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were...
I'd never leave you.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something?
The Crooked Man, Bloody Mary, the Tweedles. This is bigger than what I thought it was.
You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop?
What else could Snow do? If she didn't hand him over, my ass would be down the witching well. And Crane still would have been taken.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
All I care about right now is... just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town?
This is about those girls, and it'll always be about those girls. Nothing will change that.
We'll see. The Crooked Man declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of—
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters. To fight monsters.
Cullen, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice—
We were under attack, Snow. What did you expect me to do?
There are degrees.
Degrees? I only ever do what's necessary.
Really? Do you believe him?
Yeah, I do.
Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy.
Well, at least someone understands. Thanks, Colin.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break!
It's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow.
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for. Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you.
She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Snow come around. She's just... the crane thing hit her hard, and she doesn't really know who her friends are right now.
Oh, okay. I get it.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know? Why aren't you scared of me? Why do you care for me? When we all fall asleep, where do we go?
Come here.
Say it, spit it out. What is it exactly? Your pain is the amount cleaning you out. Am I satisfactory? Today I'm thinking about things that are deadly. The way I'm drinking you down, like I wanna drown, like I wanna end me. Step on the glass, staple your tongue. Bury a friend, try to wake up. Cannibal class, killing the sun. Bury a friend, I wanna end me. I wanna end me. What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know? Why aren't you scared of me? Why do you care for me? When we all fall asleep, where do we go?
Thanks.
I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
You can try.
You're here because the crooked man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed. If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone. And I don't know what to do.
Are you trying to say something about Faith and Lily?
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours.
Are my friends in danger?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but...
But your lips are sealed.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too.
Do you like it?
It's not how it looks that concerns me. It's what it does. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
No! These lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back! You can't do that!
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything. Okay.
If anyone finds out I came here...
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff.
Sorry, I just need to talk to the Sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was... abrupt.
That's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out.
She told me enough. I think she told both of us with the way she just left.
Okay then. Good work. So, about Beauty and Beast. Do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night?
That's what Nerissa was doing. Telling us to go there. I think she made it as clear as she could have.
You know, Beauty came to me a while back. She was looking for financial assistance. I told her there was nothing I could do, and she said that meant she'd have to go somewhere else. Bigby, you don't think she meant that she was going to go to the Crooked Man, do you?
That would explain why they called.
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
Oh. What do you want?
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
I thought you were having money problems, but it doesn't look like you're suffering to me. Snow told me you went to her for some financial help. Did you end up going to the Crooked Man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to... complicate things.
I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man? What if we talk and you don't get it? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot.
But if you'd rather deal with this on your own...
No, please don't.
Then tell me what the fuck is going on. You're in so much debt? Look around you. This isn't the way people short on cash live.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like...
All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before.
Who do you deal with?
Jersey. You know, the Jersey Devil.
Oh yeah. That slimy prick. I didn't realize he was back on this side of the river.
And those Tweedles were always going in and out. Probably dropping off a loan payment they squeezed out of some poor fable. But never the Crooked Man. Mainly it's just regular fables. I can see now that it was a mistake, but... I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
Fucking Bloody Mary must go through there. She had Woody's axe last night. Trying to chop my damn head off with it.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man'll come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And... You know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street, same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man, and I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
You're telling me that with a place like this, you're so hard up that you need to work for the Crooked Man? The guy you're so afraid of? Bullshit.
It's not like he runs the counter and hands me the boxes. I never met the guy.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this, scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
Fuck off. There are a lot of fables who have it a lot worse off than you. Or me, for that matter.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
I'm going to the Lucky Pawn. There's too much going on there to ignore. I'll have a word or two with Jersey.
You know, Bigby, once you show your face there, word is going to get out. There may be nothing left to see if you go to the butcher shop after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
It's dirty.
No, it's not.
It looks like you slept in it. In a pile of garbage.
Jack, why are you... I've seen you take a torn purse for a tenner.
Yeah, but I also got her phone number. I don't want your phone number.
Why are you never glamored, Toad? Why is it so hard to just follow the rules?
Look, I know some fables can switch from man to beast and back again, like changing shirts. But it's not so easy for the rest of us to look human, all right? And anyways, I'm getting the money right now.
I'm not taking the coat.
But it's magic!
So?
And it'd be covering a check I already wrote.
Wait a minute, that's Faith's coat.
It was Faith's coat. Look, you left it in my place. What do you expect me to do?
Yes, I think the off-sighted statute of Finders Keepers clearly states that it's his now, Bigby.
So what's it gonna be?
I don't know what to tell you. See if Cindy needs a coat. I don't know.
This is to pay for those bloody glamours, you know.
You know, maybe Snow can help you out.
How could Snow help me out?
Give you an advance. A loan or something. She's kind of in charge of the business office now.
Well, the last guy who was in charge didn't help us much, so forgive me if I don't expect anything different now.
I don't know what you're getting so steamed about. Shouldn't be that big of a shock that I'm not gonna take an ass hair coat.
No, I guess it shouldn't be, since this whole bleeding operation's just a setup for one of his shady fucking loans.
Ixnay on the onlays?
Well, I'll leave you to your business. I'm sure you'll have a lot to talk about.
Good luck with that glamour, Toad.
Fuck off!
Leave the coat.
How the hell do you expect me to get a glamour, then?
I'll give you some money, all right?
You've got to be kidding me.
Do you even know how much a glamour costs?
I've never had to buy one.
Keep your money, Sheriff. I've no patience for charity.
If you're gonna be out like this, can't you at least wear a bigger hat?
You know, it's getting old to tell the difference.
Between what?
Between the business office and fables like a crooked man, who you purportedly seek to protect us from. Either way, I'm getting screwed.
What else do you want from me?
He really grows on you. Look, I told you I work here, and I do, okay? So don't look so surprised. And before you ask, I've never seen the crooked man in here. Neither hide nor hair and all that. In fact, as far as I can tell, he's never even actually stepped foot in here.
But Bloody Mary works for him. And the last time I saw her, she had the woodsman's axe.
So?
So the last time anybody else saw that axe, it was here.
We'd never take something like that. Is this really why you came down here?
And Beauty's loan she took out.
She told you about that.
Yep. And now you're gonna tell me about it.
Look, people get desperate, and when you're drowning, anything that isn't sinking along with you looks like a life raft. The crooked man gives, and he wants things in return. And when you don't pay up, bad stuff happens. Could be anything, from the loan plus interest, family heirlooms, to novelties of a more exotic nature.
Like?
Listen, I gotta start closing up shop, so,
Close? It's the middle of the day.
What can I say? Jersey likes to run at odd hours.
I still think you're hiding something, Jack. Maybe the axe is back here.
It's not.
It was bad enough in the woodsman's hands. And if it's not here, I need to track down that psycho who had it last.
It's not here.
You better hope not.
Can't you
just... Shut up, Jack. If the Jersey Devil isn't here to answer my questions, it also means he isn't here to get in my way. So I'm gonna take a look around, as long as I've got the elbow room.
All right. Don't let me get in your way.
This is Prince Lawrence's dagger. Did he sell this?
I don't know.
How can you not know who pawned it?
I'm not here every day. And even when I am here, people sometimes dump boxes of shit. What does it matter? You don't know how hard most of us have it, do you?
I know how it is.
It was a rhetorical question, but sure, fine.
I thought you said you'd never take something like this. What happened to the axe?
Okay. Fucking jeez, take it easy. It was Mary. She took it, okay? That's all I know.
That's all you know? You don't know she almost fucking killed me with it last night?
I'm being straight here. I'm just part-time. I mean, it's Jersey who's the one who's into this stuff. He's one of the Crooked Man's boys, okay? And it'd be great if he was here to tell you all this, but he's not. So just...
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
It's not my fucking system.
But you're the guy who makes sure that...
I'm the guy that keeps shit in order, and that's it, Woody. Who calls the fucking gate? Jack? If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole.
Hiya, fellas.
Christ. And this fucking guy, too?
Bigby?
What is his ex even here?
Nope. It isn't.
Just like I said, it's not here. Happy? I got shit to do, so whatever you're here for, make it snappy.
If I were you, I'd watch my tone about now.
How's your arm? Bloody Mary leaves a bit of a sting, don't she? Jack, did you know that as of this very morning, Bigby's joined the Crooked Man's Obedience School for wayward fucking creatures? He's already passed his first class. You see, the sheriff had who he stupidly thought was the murderer. Been chasing him for fucking days, right? But the Crooked Man snapped his bony fingers, and Bigby handed him over.
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit!
Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun? You ain't so tough.
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
There she is.
Try again?
You can't find a Crooked Man. No one can. There's no address, no place. He lives in the bends and forks of tree roots, behind the sun, in the shadows.
That's not good enough.
Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror.
How do you contact him?
Oh, I don't. He uses couriers for everything. Ravens, oh, goblins, the fucking Tweedles. Whatever. I go in when I'm taken there. Oh!
The next thing you say better be something useful.
Fine. Crane had the mirror. Bloody Mary had Crane. So take your fucking wrecking crew act to the butcher shop.
The cut above. And if I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
That's her spot. That's where all the magic happens. You got what you want. Now get the fuck out of here. Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. You can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you?
Oh! Just shut the fuck up, will ya?
Thanks. Shitty brand.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie, I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing. Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it.
You're damn right it is.
All right, go do it then.
Bigby Wolf? What happened to you?
I'm looking for a piece of the magic mirror.
What?
The magic mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
What? Bloody Mary? Magic mirror shard? What kind of place do you think this is?
Don't bullshit me.
I'm not.
You need to listen to me. I know Bloody Mary hangs around here, so you need to start fucking cooperating right now.
I am.
Because, you know, Jersey, you know Jersey, right?
Yeah. He runs the pawn shop.
Yeah, that's right. He wasn't very cooperative when I went there.
Sorry. I've only been in that place a couple of times. I guess I don't know him too well.
Listen. Crane had the mirror, Mary had Crane, and she comes around here, right? If you're covering for her, I'm gonna have a problem with you, so you better think real hard about what you say next.
Sheriff, I... Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on, I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere, I'll be right back.
Butcher?
Shit.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out. I've got a bit of a mess back here. Look, can you come back tomorrow, maybe? I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff.
Listen, just calm the fuck down, okay? I just want some answers.
Okay. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johann, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both.
Just open the door, Johann, and it won't be your problem anymore.
I can't.
Why not? What's back there?
I don't know. I've never been back there.
Well, who locked the fucking door?
I'm not part of their crew. I don't know who or what goes on back there.
Crew?
The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me, took over my storage and delivery a long time ago. All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up.
Hmm.
getting chained up here.
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
Is this what those loans get you? That crooked piece of shit. So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. That symbol. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this?
What the hell is that? I know this isn't your coat. What's it doing here?
It's a coat. What's the big deal about some dirty...
Looks like Crane's. Seen some abuse. The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me?
I'm gonna take him down.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally. Things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover?
Crooked Man has something on everybody. It wasn't just Beauty and the loan. Beast was working for him. His goon, the Jersey Devil, is putting the squeeze on all kinds of fables down at the Lucky Pawn. He was even running black market magic out of the butcher shop. But that's over now, because we got the mirror. And once it's fixed, we got him. That's how Crane did it. And that's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff.
Why'd you put the hurt on Flycatcher? Were you hiding something down at the Tweedles? Or was it just for fun?
He worked for them, didn't he? I couldn't be sure that he wasn't involved, and I didn't want him interfering. I was simply endeavoring to make the search a speedy one. Surely you, of all people, can't fault me for getting overzealous in the process.
I don't buy it. I have more important things to deal with right now, but you can be sure that we're gonna have a long fucking talk about this when I'm done.
I do so enjoy our talks. I'll wait with bated breath.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
You got me. Not
necessarily. Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest?
Last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help.
tonight.
It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fable Town.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Buffkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while. Whitman, I
take it. If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So, just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No badge on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see a...
Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best.
Hey, I tried to give you money back at the Lucky Pawn, but you wouldn't take it.
I was just being polite. Ever heard of it? That wouldn't have covered the cab ride home, let alone a glamour. Please, I'm not looking for any more than to cover the big ticket damages. Not a cent more.
Here, Crane won't be getting any use out of this. Will that do?
Crane's money, eh? Well, I suppose that means it belongs to me as much as anybody. Thank you, Sheriff.
Use it to get glamoured, Toad. You got the money now, so I won't be so lenient if I catch you again. And the farm is always on the table.
Good.
But of course.
You have to understand, it's vital.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not.
For now. Did you take care of Toad?
Don't worry. I did the right thing.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy. Fine. We'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened. To Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead?
Maybe Faith and Lily weren't doing what they were told. Or maybe they just tried to leave.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
I have to say I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry. I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction. Looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So, where does Crooked Man hang out? I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
The door. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice.
Alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice. Tim, what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff.
You've just been waiting for me to show up? You knew I was coming?
That's what they told me. I don't know, they said you made it pretty clear. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way.
Fine, lead on.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up.
I get it. You have a job to do. But you gotta ask yourself if you want to be involved with this guy.
Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got.
I understand the position you're in, but you don't have to do this. There are other things you could do.
So it's just that easy?
Maybe not, but you don't want to be a part of this.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up! Thanks. Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you, sir.
You're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here?
Slavery? Kidnapping? Extortion? Murder? What would you call the wholesale corruption of Fabled Town?
I would call it the baseless accusation of a desperate sheriff. How are you certain this isn't some conspiracy against me?
It won't work.
I'm not trying to control you. I have no need for treachery, Bigby. I do everything right out in the open. But I can understand the confusion, and I'm truly sorry about the trouble all this has caused you. And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you.
Yeah. I killed them, so what?
Why kill them?
Does it matter?
Look, the fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. That you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms?
No deals. It's over, so get up.
I'd advise against that approach, Bigby.
You can't just hand me over! What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people?
Who the shit do you think you fuckers are?
Get the fuck out of here.
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him. Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. Get the fuck away from me. He's the one you fucking want.
This could have gone so well. But you just had to complicate things. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?